Hello and welcome to Outside In. My name is Steven. Today, I'm going to be looking at another air quality monitor. This one is a CO2 monitor. Now, I was on a YouTube channel last week. A guy was talking about his diesel heater, and he had a smart sensor, carbon monoxide handheld meter. I love those. And he also had a meter called a CM Tool CO2 meter that he was using to test for CO2. And I thought it looked kind of interesting. So I'm watching the video, and then he starts using his meter to test for CO2 levels. At one point, he had mentioned, wow, look at that, it's down to 385. And immediately, I was like, wait a minute, that does not sound right. 385, that is impossible. Okay, so I'm glad this happened, because I want you that's watching me to understand something. If you have a monitor that has CO2, carbon monoxide, you know, particulates and all that other stuff, but something is gnawing at you that something's not right. If your CO2 reading is, say, 400 or 385, or I've even seen one that said 330, more than likely, you have a fake monitor. Now, I'm going to be showing you in this video how to test very simply and very quickly if your monitor is fake. This is, without a doubt, 100% the best way to test if you have a fake monitor. It's crazy what they're using in these for the CO2 reading, okay? But anyhow, immediately I thought something was up when he said 385. So I went to Amazon. I looked at this meter, and it looks legitimate on Amazon, unlike other fake monitors that I've seen on Amazon. It actually looks kind of legitimate. Well, the biggest reason that I wanted to do that is because this guy was using it on his channel, and he has a lot of subscribers. So I've found that when a channel reaches a lot of subscriptions, that a lot of people that watch them, because I'm the same way, whatever tools that they're using, I'm drawn to that tool. If this guy is loving this tool, then I would love to have this tool. So I myself do the same thing. So I know that there's going to be people, and probably already has been people, that have actually bought this monitor. And I wanted to test it to see if in fact it's real or if it's fake. So no one buys it if it is fake. But the thing I want to do first, I want to show you the listing on Amazon. So let's go look at that right now. Okay, here is the tool on Amazon. It does formaldehyde, TBOC, and CO2. This detector provides accurate results for many air quality measurements, including carbon dioxide, formaldehyde, volatile organic compound, and temperature and humidity. High precision sensor in big bold letters. All right, so let's go ahead and get this, and let's use it in our shop, in our workshop, in our factory even. We can take it to work with us to check CO2 levels. Okay, so there you saw for yourself, big bold letters, high precision. Very, very good, high quality CO2 sensor is in this thing. Okay, so $30, who's gonna complain? So, without further ado, let's get to this. We're going to look at this CM tool and see, is it telling me the truth or is it lying? Let's find out. All right, let's go to the bench and we will go to camera number, it looks like 4. Okay, so here we go. All right, okay, here we are at camera number 4. Okay, this is my, I love smart sensor meters. This is my smart sensor CO2 meter, handheld meter. And this is my favorite cologne, blue. And you're like, okay, what are you plugging that for? Because I'm going to show you how to test your carbon dioxide meters for legitimacy. All right, now here we go. Now, the reason that I have my Blue Depth cologne is because just in case you don't have rubbing alcohol, and all that you happen to have is your cologne or perfume, that will work as well to test a monitor or a carbon dioxide meter for legitimacy. All right, now here we go. This is the CM tool. It has a light button so you can turn the light on or off. It has an alarm button so you can turn the alarm on or off. See, formaldehyde, TVOC, and your CO2. It has a maximum reading information, so you just flick back and forth. So that's pretty cool also. It has a calibrate button right here, So when you press this button and hold it, I think it's for 3 seconds, then it starts to go into a calibration mode. You can change your temperature from Celsius to Fahrenheit. And I love that. So way to go, CM Tool. I love that. And it says 75 degrees. My dedicated weather meter says it's 72. But it says 15% humidity. I don't know why my humidity is so low. So I may have to see if I can do something about that. But this one says humidity is 22. So that's not bad. Okay, so not too far off. My other monitor up there says 20%. So, okay, it's close. But I don't know if you've wondered why I haven't mentioned it yet. So hopefully you have wondered why I haven't mentioned it yet. But what do you see on this screen that looks rather odd? You got that right. It's the CO2 reading. Look at that, 385. What does my smart sensor say it is? Yes, 704. And this one I trust. Out of all the monitors that I've ever tested, reviewed, or owned, this is the one I'd trust the most. The smart sensor meters. Very accurate, incredibly good meters. 704, 385. Wow. Man, the smart sensor must be lying to me then. Well, let's test that. Remember I said I was going to show you how to test a CO2 monitor that you might think something's wrong with, or it's not quite telling you the truth, and how you can test that very quickly and very easily? Well, let me show you. Take your rubbing alcohol or your favorite cologne. Doesn't matter what you have. Most people have alcohol. All you have to do is put the alcohol in your hand and rub it around your hand. Now let me bring the CM Tool monitor over here and put my hand over. Look, look at that. Look at that. Watch the CO2. It's going bonkers. See, they hear the alarm. It's alarming. Your CO2 levels are very high. Now you can, like I said, you can also use cologne. So all you have to do is, it's probably the right there. Just squirt a little And look at that, 2,000, it pegged out. This went off the scale as soon as I put some alcohol around the sensor. This is a very good indication that this is fake. But then we are going to be taking it apart to see what's inside. So let's go ahead and do that right now. Switch over to the overhead. Let's see, camera two. Okay, all right, so we're done with smart sensor. And let's turn that alarm off. Let us see here. Let's zoom in a little bit. Now, I just have to remember to keep this in the screen. Okay, so yeah, I mean, the CO2 is still way high. TVOC is off the charts. Now, that absolutely could be because alcohol, cologne, all of those things are going to cause TVOC to go off the scale. Formaldehyde is not too high. So, I mean, these look kind of legitimate. I think I know what's in here. And before I take it apart, I'm thinking silver top hat. And you'll see what I'm talking about once I've taken this apart. Okay, so there it is. So this is definitely fake, but we are going to take it apart and see what makes it fake. Now, I'm pretty sure I already know what is in here because I've tested these before, and they usually all have the same kind of sensor inside that is giving the fake CO2 reading. And then let's take this apart. Whoops. Yeah, because I just need everyone to understand as well that CO2 will not really react violently to anything other than CO2. It may get messed with around the loud odor of, you know, paint or alcohol, cologne, perfume. But just like with a carbon monoxide sensor that does the same thing, it's only going to go up a few points and then it will come right back down. Like carbon monoxide usually will jump up to 311 and then right back down to zero. Oh my. Wow. Okay. All right then. Well then, I don't see what I thought I was going to see in here. Unless... All right, let me see. Oh, that's temperature and humidity. Okay, wow. What I thought was going to be in here is not in here. This don't even look like it has a TVOC sensor in it or formaldehyde. Inside of this is the temperature and humidity. This here is the power for charging it. And wow, I do not even see a TVOC sensor in here. So they're faking all the numbers. Now, like the Dialos, when I took that apart, it had a microscopic sensor in it for temperature and humidity, but I don't even see anything like that. These are just microchips. They could be using these to create calculations, but where they might be getting them from the temp humidity, because in order to do calculations you have to get numbers from something. So this one might be using the numbers from the temperature and humidity to create the fake readings for formaldehyde, TVOC, and CO2. Formaldehyde sensors, you can tell them because they have a circle in the top of the sensor with that looks like a little cloth, piece of cloth. So yeah, that's definitely not formaldehyde. That I really don't think that's TVOC. That most assuredly is not CO2. This is a temperature and humidity, so it does have that going for it. I think these little microchips are doing calculations with the numbers up here to feed the false data. That's just the inside of it. There's nothing in there. I don't see any sensors at all except for temperature and humidity up here. So it could be that they're using these little chips to create the false readings. But this is fake, totally fake. If you have one of these, please throw it in the garbage. It is no good. Do not put trust or faith in it. All right, I was just about ready to shut this video down, and actually I did shut the video down, but then I got to thinking, wait a minute, you know what? Somebody is probably gonna say, why didn't you take that all the way apart and see if there was any other sensors up there where the temperature is? So let's do that. So we'll take the board screws out so we can get the circuit board out of here, and then we can verify 100% there is nothing, like I say, on the other side of this board. Because it's one thing to say something, and it's a total other thing to actually show it. So let's show it. I don't think you'll mind this video being a little bit, another few minutes longer, so we can go in to further investigate. And as Big Clive would say, one moment, please. I love it when he says that. Okay, let's see. Okay, it just pops off. See, on the other side, there's nothing, except, I guess, some lights here. And let's pop this off, and let's have a look-see. I don't know if you can see that or not. Okay, there is a couple sensors here. There's one there and one there. Now, I don't think this is going to show up on camera. So what I'm going to do, this is the closest one I can find. It looks just like what's in that CM tool, but this is an alcohol sensor. So I am positive that sensor that is in the CM tool is in fact an alcohol sensor, because that's usually what is in these fake monitors. This is what is tethered to the CO2 reading in these fake monitors. So this here is an alcohol sensor, not CO2. The other sensor is a temperature and humidity sensor. Now I'm not going to throw this one away because I need to use it in future videos for yet another fake monitor that I have. So I'm getting ready to do another video on another monitor. Someone asked me about in the comments. She wanted my opinion. So I'm going to create a video about the Iwaki that you can buy on Amazon for $70. And we're going to do a video on that, and we're going to test to see if that is how good it is, what kind of quality it is. So, and I'm waiting on one more thing before I can do that video. And the one thing that I'm waiting on to do that video, I could have used for this video, but there's no need now because this don't even have a formaldehyde sensor in it. And don't even have TVOC. Sensor in it, and it definitely does not have a high precision that's a joke, a high precision CO2 sensor. No way, absolutely does not have that. Okay, so that was a quick discovery. Okay, so let's finish this out. Okay, well, you saw for yourself after I took that apart, there's nothing in there. I have to say there is not a TVOC sensor in this. There definitely is no formaldehyde sensor, and there most assuredly is no high precision CO2 sensor in this. So this is actually, so far, this is the most fake monitor that I've seen. So yeah, this is way really faked, big time faked. So yeah, if you have one of those, please throw it away. I have contacted the channel that was showing this and using it and put a link to it. I've contacted them, and hopefully I told them to please throw that thing away. way, it's fake. So if you're watching this video, I know I didn't mention it in the comment that I left on your channel. Don't forget, take the link down to that as well, so nobody goes and accidentally buys that. So this was the review and comparison and teardown of the CM Tool High Precision CO2 handheld meter. Because of the high precision that we put into our products, we want to make sure that we can save your life. So that's why we put high precision sensors in a plastic box that is orange. So it's got to be legitimate. It's orange. And it's got this little pokey thing on it. That's what I see on all the industrial meters. So yeah, this has got to be real. Okay. And guess what? $30. But I should not say that. Because Hotkrim has an incredible CO2 meter for $30. And it works beautifully. Go see my last video that I put up. I have tested, reviewed, paired it. That is a very legitimate monitor for $30. Now the smart sensor is $200. But it's because it's made basically for people that are going into a factory or using in their work environment. So these are high precision. These are high precision. Anyway, do not buy this monitor. Now they have another one that when you go to the website, you can choose a yellow one. That's fake too. They're both fake. They're all fake. There are other monitors that kind of sort of resemble this. And I know they're fake 100% because I've already seen other channels that showed that. So I didn't need to get it. But anybody that has a question about a monitor that you feel that may be fake or not giving quite good information, please let me know in the comments below. And I will do what I can to purchase it, test it, tear it down, review it, chew it up, and spit it out for breakfast. So you guys do not make the same mistake that the guy on that channel I was watching. Now, I'm not going to mention the channel because I don't want to mention somebody unless they actually say it's okay to do so. But anyway, very nice guy, super huge. I love his channel. I love this guy. He does incredible testing and reviewing of diesel heaters. Such a great guy, super incredible personality. But I just wanted to warn him. That's why I got this, to hopefully not only save his life, but other people who may buy this by mistake. Please do not buy this CM Tool handheld high precision CO2 meter. Please do not buy this. And if you have this, go pick it up, carry it over, and drop it into the garbage can. Or if you can, return it. Exactly, return it for your money back, if you can do that. So, hey, that's it. That is it. I hope you got something out of this. I hope this saved someone's life. If you have any doubt that your monitor may be fake, do the simple test that I just showed. If it's CO2 that you're concerned about on your monitor because it's saying 385, 330, or even 400. If you have a CO2 monitor that just sets at 400 or 410, and that's all it does, it really sets at 410 all the time, and then once in a while it might jump up to 6, 8, 900, 1,000, 3,000, 2,000, well, you may have just walked by it after you just put cologne on. So if you have a monitor that is showing low 400s and especially below 400 on CO2, do that simple test. Get some alcohol, put it in your hand, put it around the device, and if it's fake, it will go ballistic and it will start alarming. It will tell you to run for your life because you're going to die. But no, you're not going to die. You're just going to smell good for a while because you have alcohol on you now, or cologne or perfume or whatever it is that you're using. So do that simple test. If you have an air quality monitor that incorporates carbon monoxide, that is a simple test as well. If you have suspicion that your carbon monoxide is not registering correctly or is wrong, it's very simple to test that as well. All you have to do is light a piece of toilet paper with a match and then blow it out and let the smoke engulf the monitor. Now, if it's a legitimate CO monitor, it's going to go bonkers. A lot of people think something's wrong with their monitors when they've just painted in their house. Well, the paint fumes, as they're drying, like to play havoc on a lot of these sensors, but usually they'll just flicker around and they really won't, you know, go up and stay up. Now they will on TVOC and formaldehyde, so, but I'm talking about carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide. But usually the numbers go up, come right back down, go up, come right back down. They don't go up and stay up like this one was doing. Okay, with that said, that's it. I'm not going to belabor this any longer. So, like always, take care of yourself. Take care of each other. Find someone that needs a reason to go on and give them that reason. Find someone that needs a laugh. Make them laugh. Make them giggle. And in the words of Tiny Tim, God bless us, everyone. And you know what? Come to think about it, if Tiny Tim would have known about Outside In, he would have probably also said, and I will see you in the next one.